Joining us now on Zoom is head coach of Liberty Softball, Sam Corrado, who would have been entering his fifth year as the head coach for the Liberty Hurricanes. Sam, I know you actually missed last year as well because of some health concerns that you had to take care of. And now this season, obviously not going to happen because of the COVID-19 pandemic. Can you kind of just tell us what your emotions are at this point?
It's weird. I'm not feeling anything for myself because I know I can go on and coach next year, the year after, or forever long Fred Harris wants me to be his head coach. I feel bad for the kids. I mean, some of these young ladies won't be playing this sport again unless for like summer ball or something like that if they play there. But if they're going to college, the bulk of our team probably won't be playing ball again after this year.
Yeah, I can only imagine. We talked about this before. You have 13 seniors on your team. What was it like when you first had that conversation with them when they found out they weren't going to have their senior season?
It was Friday the 13th when I got the phone call saying that we had to stop everything. And I took them into our field house and I talked to them and I tried to get them to understand that, you know, this is just a setback. Things are going to bounce back. We're going to be okay, but we have to do what they say is right now. I need you to go home. I need you to rest. I need you to drink and eat right. And on your own, try to keep in softball shape. And then when we got that, I was actually at work at St. Luke's Hospital when I got the text message from my wife saying, just cancel the entire year. And my heart just sunk. I didn't know what to say. I ended up talking to a couple of the kids via a Facebook page we set up. And I just let my heart out in a little bit of a post for them. Just trying to explain to them that you can't think of this as you got ripped off. You got to think of the memories that you've created over the last 3 years. They have sent back to me on that Facebook page how they are feeling, and they're devastated, as I would think the rest of the league and the state of Pennsylvania. The rest of those kids that are waiting for their senior year are devastated and heartbroken.
Yeah, and I'm sure it's hard as a coach, as someone who really takes a lot of time and effort into helping these kids through their everyday lives. I know you said that you mentioned the Facebook group that you guys put together. Did you guys put that together because of the COVID-19 pandemic and not being able to see each other in person?
Yes. I made that page up just to keep us in touch with each other and keep our bonding and our family kind of together at that point. Last year when I was gone, I found this beautiful little essay somebody wrote about the last time they would walk on a field or walk off a field. And I put it in the field house for them to read every time to make them understand there's a time period that everybody has, you know, when they've got to stop playing or when they stop coaching or when something like this happens, you know, God forbid it ever happens again. But so the girls made a video of each one of them reading a passage from this thing, and then they combined it together. It was really, I had a lot of dust in my eye that day. I had, you know, I had to get it out of there, but I wanted to keep them positive and uplifted and hopeful that this would still happen.
Yeah, I think we were all hoping that it would still happen. And I know you have 13 seniors, and as much as we love to talk about each and every one of them, that's a lot of seniors to talk about in one interview. But let's put them all in a group, and maybe you can just explain to us what they really mean to you.
They were a very driven bunch, very intense, very focused young ladies. Like everyone else, they don't like to lose. It was a great group of kids to be around. I really wanted one more year in the sun with these kids.
Now, do you have any underclassmen that actually did play for you? I know that with 13 seniors, they might have all been the starters.
One. Her name's Tori Panic. She was our second baseman and a backup pitcher. The greatest thing is I coached her mother when I had the softball team at Northampton Community College. She was my shortstop. I found out 2 weeks before our state championship game that she was pregnant with Tori. She hit a home run in that game to win one of the games of the state championship. And I always let Tori know that you just rounded the bases to win a state championship too, so.
No, I always hear about it and I always love hearing about it because it's pretty awesome to be pregnant and still hit a home run. Softball, I would say, is definitely my life. So just not being able to play this year, a little heartbroken.
Yeah, she's something special, but she'll be a great leader for us, I think. In the next couple of years to come. I really do. The rest of those kids, honest to God, I think I have one sophomore in Tori, another sophomore in Ellie Powers, and then a junior in Madison Stefanik. and then everybody else is freshmen. So they're going to be tossed into the fire really fast next year.
Yeah, well, as unfortunate as it is, I think it's safe to say that Liberty's going to have a bit of a rebuilding year next year. But for right now, I hope you and your team continue to find those silver linings. And please stay safe and stay healthy. And we look forward to seeing you guys again.
I look forward to seeing you again and meeting you in person this time. And thank you so much for giving me this opportunity. But I'm going to tell you this last thing as we sign off. We have stuff in the works. We have some things in the works to honor these kids. So be prepared, because if we get the timing right and this virus loosens its grip enough that we can all get together, we have some people right now working on something special.
Well, TV2 Sports will definitely be there, Coach. Thank you so much.